Hello everyone, today we'll talk about occipital bone. This video was created with support of MedUniver.com. It's a flat bone and it belongs to the narrow cranium of the skull. It's formed posterior and inferior walls of the skull. Also, it is unpaired bone. It is divided into four parts arranged around the foramen magnum. It has the basilar part. At the sides of the foramen magnum are located the lateral parts. And the back is named as a squamous part. On the external part is located the external occipital protuberance, protuberance occipitalis externa. Along the midline of the squamous part until the foramen magnum runs a ridge, the external occipital crest, crista occipitalis externa. There are nuchal lines, the inferior nuchal line, the superior nuchal line, and the highest nuchal line. Here is the inner surface of the occipital bone, or facies interna, on which is located cruciform or cross-shaped eminence. Here is the internal occipital protuberance, a ridge that runs from the internal occipital protuberance to the foramen magnum calls internal occipital crest. The squamous part of the occipital bone is marked by grooves on its internal surface due to dural venous cranial sinuses, the superior sagittal sinus and the transverse sinuses. The lateral part is involved in the connection of the skull with the spinal column. It has an occipital condyle, the condyloid fossa, which has the condylar canal. Also, on the lateral parts are located hypoglossal canals, which contains hypoglossal nerve. And here is groove for the sigmoid sinus, sulcus sinus sigmoide. The basilar part. By the 18th year old, it fuses with the sphenoid bone to form clevus. There is also a pharyngeal tubercle on the inferior surface of the basilar part. This video was created with support of MedUniver.com.